Hi friends!
In our previous session, we've seen the plant tissues associated with the first plant function, which is growth. And we left y'all with an interesting question as to what is the reason for the rapid growth of the bamboo plant. Thank you for your response, which was quite close to the real reason. So let me share it with y'all. Just like all plants, the bamboo's growth is due to cell division, as we've seen in the meristematic tissues. In addition to this, these cells of the bamboo plant also elongate or increase in length, thus resulting in its rapid growth. Moving on, in this session, we'll see the tissues associated with the next plant function.
But before we move ahead, let's compare a building under construction to a growing plant. So as you know, we have compared a brick to a cell and a wall to a tissue. In a building under construction, an increase in height is because of the addition of bricks. Whereas in a plant, it is due to the addition of new cells. Now as the bricks were added, the lower portions assumes a fixed shape. In a similar way, as the plant is growing, the meristematic tissue leaves behind cells, which undergo permanent changes. Due to these changes, they can no longer divide and will hence remain or maintain their changed state permanently. And since they will remain the same way till the plant dies, they are called as permanent tissues. The process by which the cells undergo changes is called differentiation, a word which simply means to make or become different in the process of growth or development. There are two types of permanent tissues, simple permanent tissues and complex permanent tissues. Tissues if composed of only one type of cell are called simple tissues, while those made up of two or more types of cells are called complex tissues. Different types of simple permanent tissues help in food storage, providing support to the growing plant. So before we begin with the first type of simple permanent tissue, let's recall what constitutes a healthy diet. A healthy diet must include a variety of vegetables and fruits. If you realize, these vegetables and fruits are parts of the plant. And when we consume these fruits and vegetables, we are actually eating the most abundant type of tissue found in plants. It is called the parenchyma. It is most abundant as it fills in the spaces surrounding the other tissues and practically makes up the entire plant, especially the herbs and the leaves, flowers and fruits of woody plants. Now let's take an everyday life example to understand this tissue. An ice cream cone can be compared to the parenchymatous tissue both in structure and function. Just as the cones are made of the same material, in the same way, parenchyma is made up of only one type of cell. Also, as the cone helps in storing ice cream and providing support, similarly, the parenchyma also helps in storing of food in the form of nutrients and water, as well as providing support to the plant. Moving on, let's consider two different ice cream flavors. Why did we do so? Well, as we all know, the cone is the same for all the ice creams, but it is the ice cream filling that differentiates them. So also is the case in parenchyma cells. Here, the cells are similar, but depending on what is present in these parenchyma cells, they are known differently. Plants need to prepare their own food. They do so using a green pigment for performing photosynthesis. This pigment called chlorophyll is present in the cells of the parenchyma. And such type of parenchyma tissue, which contains chlorophyll in its cells, is called as chlorenchyma. There are also many plants which live in different types of water bodies. Some of these do so by floating on the water surface. I'm sure we've all seen the lotus plant or the water hyacinth. Ever wondered how they do so? Well, the cells of such plants contain air cavities, which trap air inside them. This makes the plant lighter and helps the leaves to float on the water. And such type of parenchymatous tissue whose cells show the presence of air in them are called as aranchyma. Thus, we have completed the functions and first type of simple permanent tissue. Moving on, what do you think would happen if we tried to bend the ice cream cone? It would break, right? But compare the same situation to young plants such as grasses, for example. We have all seen what happens to them during a strong wind. They tend to bend, thus lowering the possibility of their breaking. This important flexibility is possible due to the presence of another type of simple permanent tissue called collenchyma. The cells that form this tissue are elongated and thickened at the corners due to extra deposition of cellulose. This acts as a glue to hold together the cells and hence provides mechanical support as well as elasticity to the young parts of the plant, such as the leaf and the stem, thus imparting its characteristic flexibility to such plants. I hope you're all with me. Now moving on, talking about mechanical strength. Have you ever tried peeling a coconut with your bare hands? It is very difficult as the covering is very strong. This very covering is made up of another type of simple permanent tissue called this sclerenchyma. The cells of this tissue are long, narrow and dead. They are packed completely with a cement-like substance. This substance hardens the cell and provides the necessary strength. Therefore, it is also found in the outer covering of seeds and nuts. So, up till now, we have seen the tissues involved in the storage of food, which is the parenchyma, and the tissues which provide flexibility and mechanical support to the plant, which are collenchyma and sclerenchyma respectively.
But these are all only part of simple permanent tissues. And as we've said before, permanent tissues are of two types: simple permanent tissues and complex permanent tissue. So in our next session, we'll be studying the next type of permanent tissues, that is the complex permanent tissues, and the functions they perform for the plants. Don't forget to like our session and share it with your friends. Do comment and subscribe to our channel for more such interesting sessions.